In this video, we're going to look at statistical accounts. At the general ledger, all stat accounts. Now, statistical accounts are used for recording non-financial data, such as square footage of a building, number of employees, a head count, number of days sick, or number of PTO days, or work hours, or things of that nature. Here, we're using labor hours, overtime labor hours, general contract jobs, residential jobs, developer jobs. So this helps you keep track, lets you track these numbers, and you can use them in the reports, financial reports, and some custom reports to display those numbers. You can also use it to get like the amount of revenue per square foot or the expense per employee, or the number of hours total worked for an employee, or the amount of revenue created per hour of labor for the revenue from a particular job or something like that. Whatever you want to use it for, or you can just use it to say, well, this week we worked 1,000 hours with our crew and we did 200 overtime hours. Hopefully it's a large crew and not a small crew that did all that. Now, in the demo, they did something that I will always tell you not to do. They used the 9,000 range for their stat accounts. Why they did that, I do not know, because Intacct will tell you themselves that you should not use the same kind of numbering system for your statistical accounts as you do your general ledger. Why is that? Because when you go to pull a report or create a journal entry, so let's look at the general ledger report, let's say. We will go over how to pull these reports at a later time as well. Let's say you want to choose your account range. You click here and you scroll down. You don't necessarily right off the bat know that these are statistical accounts. They look like financial accounts because they're in the same list and there's nothing to distinguish them from that range. Additionally, a lot of people use the 9,000 range for their general ledger accounts for like extraordinary expenses or extraordinary losses or something like that. So it limits you. Ideally, your stat accounts should start with at least a letter, or maybe the whole thing is alpha. It can be alphanumeric. It cannot be longer than 4 digits because in this case, because that's the number of digits that our GL accounts are set to. It is limited to the same number of digits as your GL accounts, but it doesn't have to be numbers. Your GL accounts have to be numbers, but not your stat accounts. Best practice is, let's say for labor, you could call it fab H for labor hours, or you could do it for regular hours, something like that. And then in down here, you could say regular as opposed to overtime hours. Reporting type doesn't matter too much at the start, but it will eventually if you're doing a lot of calculations. For period gives you the delta for the time period or the reporting period. Cumulative carries you a continual cumulative balance. Now, the quick start categories, they don't have a lot. So a lot of times, I wouldn't even worry about it. It does have the same required dimensions as the other ones. However, locations, I take that back, locations are still required for stat accounts as well. At one time they didn't, but they do now. So locations are always required. And you want that in order to track, like especially for projects and cost codes, you might want to always be sure that's tagged to your stat accounts. You don't have to, but you may. Ideally, you'll have either alpha or alphanumeric. So you can do like save regular hours, or you could do something like labor 100. And this could be your labor. Labor hours, regular. And you see you can have up to 80 characters. This is way short of 80 characters. And click save. And you'd have it this way. This is much more identifiable. We go to ooh, general ledger, I guess leave page, and come down here to look, and you scroll down, it's much more easy to tell that they're not your GL accounts. That's why it's best practice. And that's what your statistical accounts are for. We want to be numerical data, and it can be dollar amounts, it can be counts, it can be square footage, anything like that. But it's just, it's not used on the financial side of your reporting. And when we get into the reporting modules, we'll get more into that. That's not as long as the general ledger account was. There is a template for this. It's very similar to the general ledger account, so I'm not going to go over it again. But once you see it, you'll understand it. And that's it for our stat accounts.